Today I'm showing you guys my epic binder project. What's up guys, we're back with another video and we are back with another binder weird angle video, but this is the best way that I can find that you guys can actually see most of the stuff. So let's get into it, but first we have a giveaway. I'll be giving away these three cards. All you guys have to do is like this video, be subscribed, and let me know what you think about the binder project, how I should change it up to make it better, etc. So before we get into the actual binder, I'm going to let you guys know what this is. So this is a binder that I've sort of been working on, but I just decided a couple of days ago what exactly I want to do with this. So inside is mostly ghosts and ulties. I'm going to try and collect every single ghost rare ever printed. And not only that, I want the first edition version and I want the unlimited version. Then if it's in a set where they have like a ghost rare and they also have an ultimate rare version of the same card and then like an ultra or a secret, I want to collect all three of those versions in first and unlimited as well. So I don't have a lot of the cards, but I actually do have a lot of them as well. So I kind of put them in somewhat of an order so we can kind of see what I have and what I don't have. I marked everything. I want everything to be near mint. Right now, some of my stuff is light play or even moderately played, and I'll attempt to replace those as we go. So we're going to go through this binder. I'm going to show you guys what I have, what I don't have, and what I think about every single ghost rare, like if I like them or if I don't. So let's get into it. All right, so I'm going to show you guys the first page. Oh, that page is not that interesting. You might notice there's nothing on the first two rows. So this should be the very first ghost rare, which is the Rainbow Dragon from Tactical Evolution. And then we should have the Gladiator's Assault ghost rare, which is the Chaos Neos. And of course, there's error versions. You guys know I have a graded one of the Chaos Neos from Glass. And then there's a Rainbow Dragon misprint from Tactical Evolution. There's a lot of crazy stuff. I don't know how that's going to work out with how these go in here. Down below, I do have three Rainbow Neo. So I have one first edition, but this one unfortunately is heavily played. The way I'm doing this is I mark them if they are not near mint. So this one is near mint, so I didn't bother writing on it. This one is marked heavily played, so I know that I need to replace it with a near mint at some point. So this is the first edition one that I have, and then I have an unlimited near mint. So all I need for Rainbow Neos is a first edition near mint, and I think there's a secret rare in the set as well, so I will need to get that if there is. It's really confusing how they did this, because they often had a ghost rare and then like another version, or they'd have two other versions. Sometimes they didn't though, so it's really hard to keep up with, but for now, this is what we have for Rainbow Neos. Let's go to stuff where we actually have more. So we move on here. So these pages are different because once you get into like 5Ds, there's like three of each version. So there's the Ghost Rare, there's the Ultimate Rare, and here would be the Ultra Rare First Edition, which I don't have. And then we have Unlimited Ghost, Unlimited Ulti, and Unlimited Ultra Rare. Up top, we have Honest, which is a little bit different because there's only a Secret Rare and a Ghost Rare. I do have a Ghost Rare Lightly Played Unlimited, and then I have a Near Mint Secret Rare Unlimited. So over here, I would have like a First Edition Honest Ghost Rare and then a First Edition Secret Rare. The other two would just fill it in with something else because there's not three versions. So as you see for the Stardust, we don't have a first edition, so I just have two unlimited. So I threw the unlimited over here. So here's the near mint one. This would actually go here because it's actually near mint. This is a moderately played. This will get booted out whenever we get a first edition. Light play first edition ultimate rare, and then over here would be the unlimited ultimate rare, and then we have ultra rares right here. I don't have a lot of the ultra rares just because I never really bothered keeping those in the past, but now I really want to keep them and like get them all together. I put these all in order of release. So obviously Stardust Dragon comes out in the Duelist Genesis, and then you have Crossroads of Chaos comes out next. So that's how we did this. No Ghost Rare Black Rose first edition. We do have the PSA 10, so whether or not I actually need this, it would be cool to have one. Ultimate Rare, this one is near mint first edition. This would be the Ultra Rare. Then we have an unlimited moderately played Ghost Rare, so we're going to need to replace that for near mint, and then unlimited Ultimate Rare, and no Ultra. So we got to replace that one. Next we have, so after Crossroads came Crimson Crisis. So we got the Red Dragon Archfiend Assault Mode. I was trying to show you guys this stuff. So there's the Ghost Rare. It's a lightly played one. The other two are near mint though. Red Dragon Archfiend, maybe I would actually put in a first edition one of these in an unlimited instead of the ultra. It just feels like this card should be there, but it doesn't actually fit. It's in the Duelist Genesis. It didn't get a ghost rare. It is getting a ghost rare and ghost from the past too in like 2.5 months, guys. This is exciting. And then we don't have any unlimiteds for that one, so we're working on that. I'm not going to necessarily just go out and buy all these like right away. I'm just going to slowly piece it together, but I'll have this already. So like when I get one in a collection or something like that, I can check and see if I already have it in this binder. Then we have Power Tools. This is the one I have the most of. I do have near mint ghost rare. This thing is actually really nice first edition. Let me just show you guys this. This thing's actually like almost mint, I think. It was very, very nice. I was like, why didn't I grade it? And it's because it's off-centered, I think. That's why I didn't go for it, because this is extremely good condition for a ghost rare. Obviously, we can't check the back, but we're not taking it out of the sleeves because just don't want to damage anything. But we have a near mint one of those in ghost rare, near mint ulti. We pulled this one, I think. We have an unlimited ghost rare, which is near mint. I also did not have the ultra here, but I just threw this in here. We also have another unlimited near mint. So all the power tools are near mint. And this one's not unlimited. This one's first edition. edition. So really, I have doubles of a lot. So I need an ultra rare first edition. I need an unlimited ulti and then an unlimited ultra. But I have all these extra nice ones, and I'm not going to sell like something that's near mint to mint. I'll just keep it for myself. In terms of these ghost rares, because I really like, you guys know I really like the ghost rares, especially these cover card ones with the ultis. That's why I wanted to collect the whole like span of them. Then we have the Ancient Fairy Dragon. I used to have a PSA 10 of this. That would be right there. First edition ghost rare. But now we have just the ulti. That's lightly played. We've got a very nice unlimited ghost rare. Then we've got ourselves an unlimited ulti, but this thing's lightly played. So we got a little bit of work to do, but kind of a lot going on that we have there. The next page, we are missing a lot. We do have the Majestic Star. I don't think I've ever owned the Majestic Star first edition. So this one is definitely the ghost rare we need. We need the ulti and the ultra. We do have unlimiteds for these two, which is very cool. Then we go into the Majestic Red Dragon. We have the first edition. This one's in nice condition as well. We actually got this one and I think the power tool. If you guys remember that ghost collection we bought like a really long time ago, it was that one. I think it was like $8,000 or something. It's the same one we got the Ancient Fairy and the Black Rose, that graded 10. We do have those. Those are in great condition. We have the first edition. I think did I pull this? No, the one I pulled is graded 9. Unlimited ghost jerk there as well. Then we have the Black Winged Dragon. I have all the first editions. Here, I even have the ultra rare, but I don't have any of the unlimps, and they're all near mint too. So it's looking pretty good on the Blackwing Dragon front. I think it looks pretty nice. Let's check out the ghost rare. I mean, as we go, we're going to check out a few of the ghosts. You guys know it's my favorite rarity. Very, very nice. Blackwing Dragon. I cannot say that. Very nice. I keep wanting to check the back, but obviously it's double sleeved. So the way I'm double sleeving these, I have Dragon Shield on the inside, and then I do a penny sleeve on the outside, just so I can do one upside down and one straight up. So that way, like, none of the dust gets in there and damages it, etc. So if you guys are interested in doing that yourself, you know, that's what I do. Next page, we go to the Draco Equist, which is actually, it seems like it's a way newer one, but it's not. It's just weird because it's a fusion. So then we have the Draco Equist. We've got mod play on the ghost. We're definitely going to have to up that one. We've got lightly played on that one. And then we've got lightly played on both the unlimited. Basically, I have to get a new one for all of these, but these will be nice placeholders for now. Then the Shooting Star Dragon is also a very good conditioned one that I got from that collection of ghost rares. I did not really sell any of those, except for the Ancient Fairy after I got a 10. I also have one that I am grading from that recent collection, so you guys will see that in a PSA return very soon, hopefully. Then the ulti, and we are missing all the... Wait, Starstrike Blast might not have unlimited. I don't think it does, actually, so maybe we'll just get doubles. I don't know what we'll do. Then we have the Legendary Odin. We've got the lightly played Ghost Rare and ulti there, and then over here we have two ulti unlimbs. So we do have multiple of the ultis. We don't actually need them, but I just felt like it should go in here. And after that, we have, let's see, the Junk Berserker up here. He's lightly played. Then we have our Ultimate Rare First Edition. We have another Ultimate Rare First Edition. Does Extreme Victory have Unlim? I think it does. It's actually just kind of hard to find. Leviathan Dragon, we have both the Unlimited Lightly Played. First Edition is a Ghost Rare. First Edition Ghost Rare is moderately played, and then we have the First Edition Near Mint Ultimate Rare that we pulled like probably a year ago at this point, even more. Next up is the Galaxy Eyes Photon. If you guys can see that one, let's just show it off. It's moderately played. I did have a Near Mint I was buying, and then the guy, you know, you guys have heard the story, he just bailed on me. Ulti and Ultra are both Near Mint, so that's good. So we just need to get that Ghost Rare in First Edition, and then the rest of the other three, we don't even have the Unlimbed. So on to the next page. Here's where we do not have much. So these are kind of like the Ghost Rares who were like $2 for a very long time. So we have the Utopia Ray, like if you know Duel Links, you've seen that card a few times. Utopia Ray lightly played. That's the first one I've ever owned, and I just got it in a collection, so it was kind of weird. Same thing with the Delta Rose coming up at some point. I never had one of those. We have a Neo Galaxy Eyes Photon Near Mint. I had three of these. Two were lightly played, so I went ahead and posted those on TCG Player. So you guys, if you want to like buy some of my extra ghosts, I'm posting them on TCG Player. There's two lightly played Neo Galaxy Eyes Photon Dragons on there right now. And also, if you guys want to buy anything on TCG Player, check out my TCG Player affiliate link down below. It will support the channel. You just pay the exact same amount. You just buy the cards you're already going to buy. Supports my channel. I appreciate it when you guys do that. You can even do that and buy my card, so it's like a double whammy if you guys want to do that. That'd be great. Then we go on to Excalibur, which I apparently had three of these. I had lightly played first edition. Then I have two Ghost Rare Near Mints, which if you guys remember, we actually pulled these two on a live stream. In the same live stream, I'm pretty sure. So that was insane. We got two Near Mints. So we have two Near Mint Unlimiteds and then a light played Ghost Rare. I need everything else. I don't have any of the other ones. We're getting near to the end at this point. This one, I think, is the only one I don't own any of besides the Chaos Neos and then the Rainbow Dragon, which you guys know I own anyway, but they're graded, so I don't have any raw copies. I can't remember. I think this was Shark Drake. It's the Abyss Rising one. That's the one I don't have. Then I have Heart Earth Dragon. I actually have another of a Near Mint copy in my Blue Eyes binder or my Blue Eyes deck that is in first edition. So I actually do have that card, but it's in, you know, a deck right now. Then we got the ulti we pulled, so we're doing okay on that one. We got like 3 out of 6. And then we've got the Tachyon Dragon, which... If you guys remember this Tachyon Dragon, this is the one we opened like 300 packs to get. Like, we actually opened the ratio and more to get this thing. So yeah, that was pretty crazy. That's why we're holding on to it, because we really appreciate the journey. And next we have what? Star Eater. We don't have a ghost. I don't have a Star Eater ghost. I've been looking for one of those for forever. We've opened tons of Judgment of the Light, getting those Chickalattes. We can never get the Star Eater ghost or even the ulti. I think I got an ulti in the collection, so it'll be right here. I think I forgot to put it in there. And then, of course, the Felgrand. I got one of these from SEMO. I think it was maybe this one. I can't remember. It was like borderline light play near mint, but for me, I'm just like, I call everything that's like even close light play. Then this one's near mint, and we also had another one that I ended up selling. I think it was like even worse than light play. It was a little bit worse. And then I have the Secret Rare. I've never gotten the ulti of this somehow. We've opened quite a bit of Shadow Specters. I've never gotten the ulti. And another one I'd never owned was the Mobius, the Mega Monarch. I'd never owned this one until these last couple collections. They both had one. So one had a near mint first edition Ghost Rare. That was big. Then a lightly played unlimited. So those are what we have for that one. I don't have any of the ultis or anything. And of course, the Bujin Amaterasu, but I have a moderately played first edition. I have the unlimited Ghost Rare. I have a couple of the, they're both unlimited. So I need a first edition ultimate rare as well. Satellar Knight Deltaros. I actually found this in one of my other binders. Like, hey, I have this card. Ultimate rare, the ghost rare I did not have, but we did get this in a collection. Moderately played, we'll have to replace that one. The Dark Rebellion, the same way. I also had this in a different binder. So we have the new Challengers ultimate rare, and then we have the ghost rare moderately played, which is cool. And we're getting really close to the end here. Now we have the Malakota, I think is the name, is the first ghost rare we ever pulled. We opened an entire case of Secrets of Eternity just to pull it. I had a few of these. I think one another moderately played, so we sold that one. This is just a first edition, so we need unlimited. Does Secrets of Eternity have unlimited? Then the Clearwing Synchro Dragons. We have two of those, both first edition actually, and then both first edition here. So we do have the secret rare, because in this, at this point, they had secret rares as the third version rather than ultra. So you could get ghost, ulti, and secret in the same set. It was really weird. But yeah, we have a lot of those because we opened like 100 packs at one point. And then one that I really love, the Red Ice Flare Metal. If you guys saw the TCG player video, I actually bought a near mint one of these. So hopefully it is near mint. It can replace one of these. We got the ulti, we got the secret. Those are both near mint. And then we need the unlimited version. This actually is the unlimited ghost rare. So that's nice. All right, and we're to the very end. This is the last ghost rare before they started printing them again, the Scarlight Red Dragon Archfiend. If you haven't seen all those videos where we went crazy, we pulled four of them. It was insane. Here are the two of the four that I pulled. The other two were for a viewer, so. Then I have a third one that was near mint. I don't know where that came from. Somehow I have three of these first edition. I don't even know if they have unlimited. Then we have the ulti and the secret rare, because obviously we opened a lot of that set, so we got all of those. Then a really cool thing that worked out really well is Gold Series Haunted Mine has six ghost rares, so they just fit right across. So you just put all six. We got the Blue Eyes, the Gores, Herald of Perfection, Naturia Barkion, MST, and Solemn Judgment. So it fits perfectly right across on that row. And then another way that it worked out was we have the Winged Dragon of Ra down here. The Winged Dragon of Ra and then the five Ghost Rares from Ghosts from the Past 1 right here fit into six. So it works out perfectly that all of those are on there. There's one Stray Lamb, though. We have the Clearwing Synchro Dragon. That's going to work out perfectly when we have that Ghost from the Past 2. We throw those up there on the top row. It's going to look pretty good, I think. And that ends it for the Ghost Rare Binder, guys. Let me know what you guys think. We are missing a lot of cards, but I think we have some pretty good progress going here. I mean, there's a lot to gain, and hopefully eventually we can complete this binder. I'm not going to try and complete this thing in like the next 5 weeks or something. Like, it's going to be a long-term project that I'm going to piece together, and it's going to be fun to, like, you know, add something in if we get in a collection. Maybe we could have like a series where we're chasing the ghost rares that I'm missing from this binder, or that we need them in near mint or something like that. We buy a set and we go for them. I think that'd be a lot of fun. Let me know what you guys think down below. If you guys enjoyed the video, make sure to subscribe for more epic content. Shout out to TCG Trust Cards, Stone Info Show, Tomato Juice, Noah J, Stanley, Mike, Nance, Bambi, Gaggle, Duelist, Game Cards, Spanky McFarland, G Raider, and Daxter. Thank you guys for supporting the channel, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace.